play me, then you bump me. I can't wait to see what happens next.
Oh. I'm going home for Thanksgiving.
I can help get you home.
Taxi!
I've got a family waiting for me.
Here we go.
I have diners. Pizza and a gasoline car.
Have mercy.
I've been wearing the same underwear since Tuesday.
I can vouch for that.
Well, it's crazy. It's rock and roll. It's rhythm and blues. It's comedy. It's country. It's front porch. It's down home. It's nasty, you know.
So Jesus at McDonald's and big guy.
I was interested in the blues guys that were at the outer limits of blues. I wanted him to be Voodoo Agnew. He said, no, I got another name, Skid Roper.
Golly, is it like Bon Jovi? And I go, no, it's not. You know.
He's offending half the theater and the other half's going nuts. Well, I was going nuts.
Essentially, it's just, you know, this is big.
Destroy all our I got this video. I got Winona Ryder to play Debbie Gibson.
Oh, if you make a video, let me be Debbie G.
It was pretty apparent to Mojo they were never going to run the video.
Putting him on the air sends a signal automatically. We're still rebellious.
No. You're misreading my face there, Mr. Buchanan.
You know, Enigma Records is getting ready to collapse.
He had no illusions anymore, which meant the leash was off, the muzzle was off.
Whatever line there is, we have crossed it and taken a shit on it.
Carpe diem, rock and roll, all day, every day.
I fully expected Mojo was going to die on stage during those Toad Liquor shows.
I am going to try to incite a riot.
I mean, sometimes you just got to cut loose, rah! You know, and just be free, you know.
Government of the earth.
When I first heard the pitch, the idea for Reading Rainbow, I thought, what a great idea. Let's use the medium of television to steer kids back in the direction of literature and the written word. Because my mom was an English teacher in the first part of her life. Before she became a social worker, she was an English teacher. And I know that my life has been immeasurably enhanced by my love of the written word.
I didn't like some of the humor in the 9-to-5 script, so I turned it down.
I got some flack working with Jane, being such a radical gal.
Women work because they have to, and they're getting angry, and they're beginning to organize all around the country, and I support them, and I'm going to make a movie.
Everybody was very nervous about the movie because it was three female leads.
The core message in 9-to-5 was, you deserve better.
Women said, wait a damn minute. I'm not going to take it anymore.
Don't put up with shit. Demand respect.
All of those things about 9-to-5, the movie, women are still fighting for.
It's so important that women realize that they're seen.
But my Lord, it's 40 years now, and it's still important.
We've got so much more to do.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, baby, getting by. It's all taken and no giving, baby, just use your mind.
It's just you and I doing cool stuff. It works every time.
Yeah, it's also a one-day trip.
Yeah, but if we do a montage and build a passage of time...
Okay. It just feels a little cliche.
You know what, Devin? That's because it is cliche. But it's what the people want.
To history, and you have the wherewithal to synthesize it into something digestible and, God forbid, fun, it's our job to draw those patterns, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because as humans, once we recognize and reckon with where we've been, we might learn a lot about where we are, and more importantly, where we're going.